mathematics subject, and we are going to part through our topic, which is the approximation. We shall pass some few concepts concerning approximation and related concepts with the approximation. First of all, let us see what is approximation, what the meaning of approximation. And simply, we say that approximation is the process of increasing or decreasing a number. We say that approximation, we are talking about increasing or decreasing a number. Approximation is mainly concerning the increase or decreasing a number, but this we say that to a desirably placed value, to a desirably placed value. Okay, the concept of approximation is to cover the increase or decrease a number. When we talk about a number, then we have this desired place value. We are meaning those place values occupied by a digit. Those place values occupied by a digit. What the meaning behind? It means that, for instance, we have our number. We have our number, let's say, 205. We have our number 205. Here we have three digits. We have three digits, which we have 2, we have 0, and 5. These digits, they occupy the place value. They occupy the place value. And the place value we are talking about, you mean that 5 is in ones, 0 is in tens, 2 is in hundreds. So we have ones, tens, 100. That's the concept. So when we're talking about approximation, we mean that we increase a number or we decrease. We either increase or decrease. A number to a desired place value. So after knowing the concept of approximation, now let us see the process which we call it rounding off number. Okay. We say that to round off a number, we have some principle. We have to obey. First, we say that check the digit to the right. This is very, very, very important concept on approximation. Mean that on rounding off a number, we have to check the digit to the right. What the meaning of the concept of digit to the right? Take example. For instance, you are given 178, then you are required to round this number or to approximate it to tens. Mean that first of all you have to trace the required place value. 8 is in ones, 7 is in tens, and 1 is in hundred. Mean that this is the required place value. This 7 is the required place value. Then the process of approximation is accompanied with the rounding off number. And to rounding off number, the main concept of rounding off number, I mean that you have to check the digit to the right. You mean that if the required place value is this 7, digit to the right is 8. So I want you to be very, 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 very careful with the process of rounding off numbers before seeing some rules which are accompanied by getting the desired place value. So first of all, you have to know that to round off a number, you have to check the digit to the right. Mean that the required place value is 7. To this example, digit to the right is the 8. Okay, now let us see what to do now if we have to obtain the digit to the right. Okay, we have some number of rules. Rule number one, say that if the digit to the right is 0, 1, 2, 3. And or let's say 4. If the DBT to be right is 0, 1, 2, 3, or 4. We say that the number will remain unchanged. The number will remain unchanged. We say that the number will remain unchanged. The number remain changing. And they say that the rest of the digits will replace it by zero. By zeros. Okay, well, let's see what is the concept behind that. The first rule of approximation. We say that on round off we consider the digits to the right. Then what happened to the digit to the right if it is ranging from 0 to 4? If it is ranging from 0 to 4. Take example. Given 2, 0, 4, 5, 2, 1. For instance, we are given that number, then we are required to round it to hundreds. We are required to round it to hundreds. To hundreds. First of all, you have to find the required place value. Okay. This is 1, this is 10, this is 100. Mean that you can see now the 5 is on the required place value. The 5 is on the required place value. Then you have to check the DBT to the right. The DBT to the right is 2. Mean that it obeyed the first rule, mean that it's ranging from 0 to 4. We see that the number will remain unchanged. Then the rest of the DBT will be replaced by 0. So this one will be approximated as 2, 0, 4. Then we have 5. This 2 and 1 will be replaced by 0. Be replaced by 0. So this number, if it is approximated to hundreds, it will be given by that. I mean that the rest of the number with the test digits will remain and change up to the required test value. The rest of the digits will be requested by 0. So you have to be very, very careful on that. Let's see a second example. For instance, given 2.4403. Then that number you require it to round it to 100. You have to be very careful on this because the 100 and the hundreds are they are different. I mean that when you talk about 100, we mean that those positions of value are taken by the decimal digits, by the fractional part of the decimal number, fractional part of the decimal number. I mean that this, on decimal, this is 10. On decimal, this is the 100. This is the 100. I mean that our required place value is actually 0. The DBT to the right is exactly 4. The DBT to the right is 4. According to our rule there, we say that the number will remain unchanged and the rest of the digits will be replaced by 0. Mean that from there, this number will be approximated as 2, decimal 4, then it will be 0. The rest will be replaced by 0, but because of this decimal point, they are not a significant figure. Mean that no need to indicate them, so they will remain as 2, decimal 4, 0. 2 decimal 4, 0 today. Ready? Let's see. Right. Okay. That is rule number 1. Now let us see rule number 2. Rule number 2, we say that. Rule number 2, we say that. If the DBT to the right, is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then one is added. Added to the required test value. Required test value. Okay, the rule number two says that if a digit to the right is ranging from 5 to 9, then we say that 1 is added into the required accuracy value. Okay, let's see some examples. For instance, yes. Example concerning the second rule. For instance, maybe you are given maybe 275. Sorry, 2075. Then you are required to round it to tens. Required to round it to tens. According to the rule, we say that if the digit to the right is ranging from 5 to 9, that one will be added to the required place value. Then, from there, you have to trace the trace value of the number. This is 1s, this is 10s. So, meaning that this 7 is on the required place value. Then, you have to change the DBT to the right. DBT to the right is 5, which is lying on that row. Meaning that 1 will be added, 1 will be added to the DBT in the required place value. 1 will be added. So, this number will be equals to 20 to be 8. The rest of the digits are replaced by 0. So that this 5, we want to indicate it to mean that we replace it by 0. So that 2075 will be approximately to 2080 to 10. So you have to be very careful on that. Now let's see example 2. We say that for instance, we're given the number like this one. 2, 4, 5, 6, 8, 3. Then you are going to round it to thousands. You are going to round it to thousands. In that, first of all, you have to trace the required place value. The required place value. This theorem is ones, tens, hundred, thousands. So from which this 6 is on thousand, then you have to check the DBT to the right. DBT to the right, you can see now, it is 8. Meaning that it is like on the second rule, which is that if the DBT to the right is about 5, 1 will be added to the required place value. So from which this will be given to 2, 4, 5. Instead of writing this 6, 1 will be added. So from which we get 7. The rest of the DBT are replaced by 0. The rest are replaced by 0. So you have 0, 0, 0. Then this is the number which is approximated to thousands. Let's see the third example. Example 3. For instance, you're given 0.267. Then you are required to round it to 10. Going to round it to 10. Mean that first of all you have to trace the required place value, the digits, from which you say that on decimal we have we don't have ones, we have the 10, mean that the first digit after the decimal point is 10, this is 100, this is it. So you can see that the 10 is this one, so the required place value is that one. Then you have to check the digit to the right. Digit to the right there is 6, and if it's 6, means that it is lying on the second rule from which 1 will be added. 1 will be added. So, mean that that will be approximately 0 decimal. If you add 1, it will be decimal 3. The rest are replaced by 0, but because of this decimal point, they are not significant figures, so we want to indicate them. We want to indicate them. Now let's see rule number 3. Rule number 3 says that if the DBT to the right yeah,
Peter David be writing is 5 and the number on the required place value. Place value is all. Then say that it. 1 is added. 1 is added. 1 is added. Okay. The third rule of our approximation theory, if the digit to the right is 5, what the meaning of it? The meaning is if the digit to the right is exactly 5, not above or below, is exactly 5. Then we say that the number on the required place value is odd. Meaning that this rule is accompanied by two rules. If the digit is 5, then the number on the required place value is odd. Meaning that here we are talking about those odd numbers, which we have studied on the topic of numbers, the topic 1. Okay, those odd numbers, I think that you are aware of those numbers. Then 1 is added. 1 is added. What do they mean? The meaning is, for instance, if the digit we have this 35, we have this 35, then you are required to round it to 10. Meaning that this is 1, this is 10. So you can see, this is 10, this is 1. The digit to the right is exactly 5. Digit to the right is exactly 5. And the number on the required place value is odd. We say that 1 is added. So 1 will be added there, which will be 40. The rest is replaced by 0. Then you get 40. This concept, you have to be very careful on it because, first of all, you have to, the digit to the right must be exactly 5, not above or below 5. Not above or below 5. It must be exactly 5. Okay, now let's see some few examples. Concerning the heavy rule. Example 1. Given 2, decimal 6, 3, 5, then you are going to round it to 100. First of all, you have to find the required place value. The required place value, this is 10, this is 100. So you can see that this area is on the required place value. Then you have to check the digit to the right. Digit to the right is exactly 5. Digit to the right is exactly 5. And this third rule is applicable when the digit to the right is exactly 5. Then the digit on the required place value is odd. 3 is odd number. 3 is odd number. And then you say that 1 is added. 1 is added. So 1 will be added. So that 1 will be equal to 2 decimal. It will be 6. If you add 1 there, you get 2, 4. It will be equal to 4. So this 2.685 to 100 will be approximated to 2 decimal 64. That is the concept of the third rule. Let's see example 2. Let's see example 2. For instance, given 2, 5, 6, 7, then you have 3, then 5. Then you're required to approximate it to 10. Approximate it to 10. Meaning that you have to find the required place value. This is 1, this is 10. So you can see, this is odd number. The digit to the right is exactly 5. Meaning that 1 will be added. So that one will be approximated as it will be 2, 5, 6, 7. Then there will have 4. 0 will be there, will be replaced. The last digit will be replaced by 0. So that is the concept of the third rule. Okay, now let's see the last rule of this rule, of this part of approximation, which is concerning the digit to the right, which is exactly 5, and the digit on the required value is even number. Is even number. Okay, let's see. Rule number 4, we said that if the digit to
to the right is 5 and the digit on the required place value less value is even. Is even. We say that we have the first part. We say that it will remain unchanged. To remain unchanged if after 5 there is no any non-zero digit. Non-zero digit. Secondly, we say that here, 1 will be added. Want to be added if after 5 there is another non-zero digits, then 1 will be added. Okay. Rule number 4, you have to be a little bit careful. Because we say that if the digit to the right is exactly 5, that is 1, then the digit on the required place value is even. Here we are talking about those even numbers. If this condition occur on the question, mean that we have the another subsection which is you have to observe them in order to get the required place value. The first thing we say that it will remain unchanging if after 5 there is no any non-zero digits. There is no any non-zero digits. Mean that if also there will be the zero digits, it will still remain unchanging. Secondly, we say that 1 will be added if after 5 there is another non-zero digits. Okay, let's see some few examples accompanying that rule. Let's see example 1, which is on this first part. On this first part, we say that the digit to the right is 5, and after 5, there is no any non-zero digits. Let's see. Given 5, 6, 5, 0, 0. Then you are required to round this towards 100, to hundreds. Then you are required to round that number to hundreds. You have to count ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. Let's approximate to thousands. We have ones, tens, hundred, thousands. So you can see 6 is on the required place value. 6 is even now. Digit to the right is exactly 5. And after 5, there is no n non-zero digits. You have to be very careful. Here we have 0, 0. But the concept here, we say that non-zero digits. Non-zero digits. Mean that if zeros will be there, simply it will remain unchanged. So that is the concept. It will remain unchanged. So this one to thousands will be equals to 5, 6. The rest are replaced by 0. 0, 0, 0. It will remain unchanged. Meaning that no any number will be added there. So the rest will be replaced by 0. Let's see example 2. Example 2, let's say given
2 is small, 6 is 5. That one, maybe you're going to round it to 10. First of all, you have to change the DBT on the required place value from this. This one is 10. If this one is 10, DBT to the right is exactly 5. And after 5, there is no any other digits. This 6 is even. DBT to the right is exactly 5. We say that it will remain unchanged. So this simply, it will be equal to 2 decimal 6. This will place the 0, but because of this decimal point, no need to indicate. So it will be that one. Okay. Let's see this rule number 4, but on second section, which we say that 1 will be added if after 5 there is another non-zero digit. There is another non-zero digit. What is the concept? The concept is, let's take example 3. For instance, even 4, 5, 6, 5, 3, 4, 2. Then you are going to approximate it to 10,000. First of all, you have to find that in 10,000. This is ones, tens, hundred. This is thousands. This one is 10,000. So you can see 60 is on the required place value. DBT to the right is exactly 5. DBT on the required place value is even. This is even now. Then, after 5, there is other non-zero digits. There is other non-zero digits. You have 3, you have 4, you have 2. We say that according to this subsection, 1 will be added. 1 will be added. So, there it will be equals to 5, 4, we have 5, 4, 5. This one, 1 will be added. So, it will be equals to 7. The rest are replaced by 0. Meaning that this 5 will be replaced by 0. This also 0. You have 0. You have 0. So this is how this rule number 4 is applicable. Let's see another example. Example 4. For instance, you're given maybe 4, this more, 6, 5, and then 3, 4. Then you are going to round this to 10. Quite to round it to 10. To 10, you mean that the required place value will be that one, 6. Digit to the right is exactly 5. And after 5, there is other non-zero digit. According to this rule, remember that 6 is even, and the digit to the right is exactly 5. But if after 5, there is other non-zero digits, 1 will be added. According to this subsection, we can see 1 will be added. So that one will be approximated as 4 decimal. Here it will be 1 will be added, from which we get 7. The rest are replaced by 0, but we won't indicate them because of the decimal point, meaning that they are not a significant figure. Okay, thank you very much. Up there, we shall end there. Until next time, I'll try to see some questions which will be posted on the website to try the concept which we will explain. Thank you very much.